So I'm guessing if you clicked on this video, you have also been fed the mythical mushroom aesthetic that, much like the fungi it's based on, has been spreading across the internet over the past few years. Things like dresses, decor, artwork, and especially the mushroom hat. And I'm here to say that I am not immune to the spore propaganda. It's just so stinking cute, alright? And what really put me over the edge was at a con last year where I saw this art print, which combines the mushroom and witch hat into one. And from that moment I knew that I must make this for myself. And today is that day. I will continue my strive to ignore my real life responsibilities and instead attempt to become the mushroom cottagecore witch of my dreams. That or I'm going to look like someone tried to create a D&D character of Toad, which, if I'm being honest, also sounds pretty fun. Now, speaking of escaping into fantasy worlds, before we get started on this project, this seems like a fantastic time to tell you about this video's sponsor, Audible. So being a YouTuber is not my full-time gig. I mean, that much is obvious by just looking at my upload schedule. It's only like once every 2 months. I actually work an office job as a full-time graphic designer, which means I have to commute and sit in traffic every single day. And let me tell you, if it was not for Audible, I think I would have lost my sanity on these drives. Being able to spend that time listening to audiobooks and letting myself get enthralled in narratives, it has turned something that I despise doing every day into personal time that I genuinely look forward to now. Plus, Audible has thousands of titles to choose from. Recently, I listened to Tomorrow and Tomorrow and Tomorrow by Gabrielle Zevin, which is a story about two childhood best friends which end up pouring their heart and soul into creating video games together. And it ends up being this masterful deep dive into the relationship of creative collaboration and what defines success and failures as artists. Honestly, it is one of those stories that you just can't stop thinking about once you finish it. You can be finished with the story, but the story will never be finished with you. As an Audible member, you get to choose one title a month from their catalog, and you also get unlimited access to any of the titles in the Audible Plus catalog. New members can try Audible free for 30 days. Visit audible.com/justlesscreative or text Just Less Creative to 500-500. Thank you again, Audible, for sponsoring this video. Now, let's get into this project.
Alright, so when I was trying to figure out how I'm actually going to make the hat, I kind of want to avoid sewing as much as possible because it scares me. I have a sewing machine and I know how to make a straight stitch on it, and that's about it. But you know what I do know how to use? Foam. Yep, I will use foam in just about anything. So I ended up finding this fantastic tutorial by SKS Props on how to make a witch hat out of EVA foam. I'm going to be using their tutorial to make the base of my hat. They have a super easy pattern for download, which I'm going to be following, and I'll leave a link in the description to their video if you also want to follow and download their pattern. So let's go ahead and get started making that pattern now. Have our two patterns made out of EVA foam. I love that this foam donut just like turns into the perfect witch hat brim. You know, I often get questions on my channel asking like, how did you learn how to bookbind? Where did you learn how to make a diorama? Where did you learn how to do all this stuff? And this is the perfect example of YouTube. Literally everything from YouTube. The SKS tutorial is a perfect example where like these patterns are really simple, but do you know how long it would have taken my two brain cells to figure out I had to make a foam donut to make a witch hat? Even though I made these pieces out of foam, I really don't want the final product to look like it's made out of foam, which is why we're going to be taking this red felt and we're going to essentially be covering it and gluing it onto the pieces. That way we can get the sturdiness of the foam, but it's going to have that more fabric look to it. And I get away without having to do any sewing at all. Let's see if this works.
Okay, for gluing this much foamed fabric together, my usual tacky glue probably isn't going to be that efficient. So I'm trying out this fabric glue spray and just hoping it works on foam.
That's so much.
At first I didn't think it was working that well, it kept peeling off, but then I actually read the instructions.
Allow to dry for 3 hours. Okay, to be fair, 3 hours is a long time, but I really only gave it like 5 minutes. And I was like, why is it not sticking? Yeah, so I'm the problem. Okay, so let's move forward to putting this on the whole project. I'm going to give it a proper amount of time to dry. Maybe not 3 hours, because 3 hours is a long time, but we'll see.
After gluing everything down, my plan was to let it dry overnight, but somebody decided that this was their new favorite spot to sleep. As much as I love having Mumbo's cat hair all over my projects, she had to be evicted.
Alright, it's a new day, and these pieces have had plenty of time to dry, and they seem to be holding up alright, but before we can start putting these together, to make this actually look like a mushroom, we need to give it those ripple, you know, those things underneath. Is their official name for it?
Underside of mushroom.
Mushroom anatomy, a deep dive into the mushroom parts. Perfect.
Lapella?
Is it a lamella? Or gills? I'm just going to call them gills.
Yeah, I'm not 100% sure how I'm going to add the gills, but I do have some white scrap fabric and a hot glue gun, and I think I'm just going to wing it.
I mean, there's not many problems a hot glue gun can't solve, if I'm being honest. But I think I have a plan. If I just scrunch it up and glue it on, I think it'll make those ripples. I really don't have any other ideas, so let's just try it.
Alright, so for a bit more context of what I'm doing here is I'm essentially gathering up the fabric around the center of the hat and then hot gluing those folds together and then repeating this all around the circle. The closest thing I can compare it to is pleating, but I don't even know if it's necessarily that. If anyone knows a better way that I was supposed to do this, can you please let me know in the comments, because I was just truly guessing on this part. The laws of physics eventually caught up with me, leaving this empty space. To which I just cut off the excess around the hat and started just gluing random strips there.
Yeah, this part's gonna look a little bit messy, but I'll just make it the back of the hat, it's fine.
Now with the full circle complete, taking even more hot glue, I fold over and glue down the edges. I poke a lot of fun at myself for how much I use hot glue in projects. But even when I use it, I always make sure to take my time so the project still looks neat at the end. Hide away any evidence that this is just being held together by hot glue and hope. And with that, we have the brim of our mushroom hat. And as you can see, I am very pleased that I am one step closer to becoming a magical fey mushroom being. But obviously, we are not there yet. Time to make this a real witch hat. EVA foam along the edge is going to be used to help glue it together. As suggested from the SKS tutorial, I take apart a wire hanger and glue that to the inside of the cone. Y'all remember when I was talking about being neat with hot glue like a minute ago? Yeah, that doesn't matter right now.
If it looks ugly, that's because it is. It's going on the inside, no one's gonna see it. It doesn't gotta look pretty.
And to make sure it has a strong bond, I use super glue to attach it. It was during this time that I realized something kind of funny.
Guys, I just realized I accidentally made like the perfect gnome hat. Witch hat doesn't work out. I can make a sick Juliet from Gnomeo cosplay.
I was also told by my roommates that I'd make a good over the garden wall cosplay as well, but alas, this must become a witch hat. I attached it with super glue and reinforced it with hot glue on the inside to make sure that it would stay in place. And here we have a very impressive witch hat slash traffic cone, which is definitely a look, but not essentially what I want. So I tried filling the cone with some stuffing so it wouldn't cave in on itself, and then curving the wire that we installed inside the hat. But as I started curving it, I slowly realized I didn't like it. You know, at first I didn't think I would miss the cone, but I really miss the cone. This one isn't bad. Like, I do like the silhouette from some angles. Yeah, the back looks really weird. I really thought this is how I wanted the hat to look, but I want to go back to the cone. Oh well, time to de-wonkify. So I started unbending the hat and trying to return it to its previous form, but still messing around with having some organic curve in it. All right, I am finally happy with how the hat looks. Now the base of our hat is done, we can move on to decorations. And the first thing that I want to make for this mushroom hat is to add even more mushrooms to it. You know those mushrooms that grow on trees and make those little platforms that go up along it? I don't know if that makes sense to have a mushroom with mushrooms growing on it. Maybe? I don't know. It makes sense to me.
Now to go alongside with the witch hat, I'm thinking a really cool wizard, druid, witch, magical staff. Something to go along with the magical forest dweller vibe. But what am I going to use to make a whole entire staff? Well, I'll tell you. This really cool stick that I found. I would be the coolest kid on the playground if I walked up with the stick. I used to live near a beach and this was a piece of driftwood that we found. Ended up taking it home just because like, oh yeah, I could use this for something one day. And it's kind of just been sitting around. I mean, it looks like it was meant to turn into a wizard staff. So today is finally the day. So same way as the mushrooms I make for the hat, I'm going to be making some on here and having it go down and like decorating it with like moss and floral and stuff like that. So it should be pretty cool.
To make these mushrooms, I'm going to be sculpting them out of foam clay.
Mumbo, do you know how much cat hair I've had to take off of here, Mumbo?
After evicting Mumbo one more time, it was time to get sculpting these mushrooms. Carefully, I score the underside to make those gills. And now we have our first mushroom of many more to come. All right, the shelf mushrooms for the hat are done, and now it's time to move on to the staff. This is the artwork I'm loosely basing it off of, but mine is going to be using the classic red and white mushrooms for mine. I was only able to get through about 4 of the larger mushrooms until I ran out of my foam clay, so I had to wait another day for a quick supply refill. And now all the sculpting is done.
Alright, so we're actually going to be moving back to the hat while we wait for the other mushrooms to dry. Overall, I want the hat to look like the entire thing is a mushroom, and right now it has the color and it has the gills, but what it's missing are those iconic spots to make it look like that mushroom. You know the mushroom I'm talking about. Gosh, I have to look up so many mushroom terms for this video. It says Amanita muscaria. Why do mushrooms have such hard names to pronounce? So we're going to have to paint those on top. And I think the best way to get the most realistic look, I'm going to be using the airbrush. So shiny and fancy. The airbrush is going to be the best tool, I believe, to not only paint fabric, but to also get a nice gradient on it. All right, let's get started.
Before actually getting to the spots, I'm actually going to mix together a more burnt red that is just slightly darker than the red of the hat. This is going to be used as a sort of shading around the rim of the hat. It will be a pretty subtle effect, but it just helps it not be as flat. I also add some at the seam and the top of the hat as well. It's such a small detail, but I really love the effect it has. Same for the underside of the brim, but this time with a more light tan color. To try and make those ridges pop a little bit more. However, I do wish the color didn't look so much like I accidentally smudged foundation on clothes. Oh well, it looks fine, and now we can move on to the spots. I didn't really have a plan of where I wanted the spots to go. I was just started with one and added as I saw fit, trying to make them vary in shapes and sizes. Once I was pleased with the spot placement, it's time to move on to painting the mushrooms. Now that the mushrooms are all dry, we can prime them with flex spawn. You know that they'll be primed for painting as soon as they dry, shiny and glossy. I decided on a light tan color in hopes that it would contrast with the red.
though it does make them look like some weird clams as they're drying. As for the top of the mushrooms, the ones on the hat get a dark burgundy color, and the ones going on the staff get a bright ruby red. I love the airbrush because it's such a smooth application, but I also hate that it's so messy and so loud. I'm super happy with how the mushrooms turned out, but I think it's also started to turn me into a mushroom as well. So I decided to finish off the last remaining dots by hand.
This is really stupid, but it made me laugh. Among Us on the fungus. So stupid.
Finally, all of our mushrooms have dried and been painted and are ready for the final assembly. Not only is it going to be getting the mushrooms, but if you saw my last video, it's going to get one of my favorite things added to it. An absolute ton of moss and fake foliage. All right, with that being said, let's finish this up and into the final reveal. I always love adding fake foliage because I feel like it brings a new life to a project. And especially with this one, the greenery just pops so well against all the red. It's also great to cover up any seams or gaps to make the whole thing blend together a little bit better. And with a few last touches, the project is finally complete. This was such a fun project to do, so I hope that you guys enjoyed watching it. If you so happen to stumble upon my channel and want to see more projects like this, please consider subscribing. And we're kind of getting close to 100k subs, so that would be pretty cool. As always, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see y'all in the next one.
Last time we were on this trail, there was mushrooms. I'm really disappointed now. How am I supposed to have whimsy in these conditions?